welcome to Yoga for Your Third Trimester and Preparing for Birth. This is a short sequence that can really help to ground and support you, to help you channel your inner strength and power and connect with that deep inner wisdom that's going to really help carry you through this time. We're going to be doing some gentle movements to help sort of bring a sense of awareness into your pelvis, to tone and support the structures around your pelvis and to connect with your breath as well. So we'll start in a comfortable seated position. So have a bolster here to sit up onto. You might have a blanket or a cushion to sit onto, just to give yourself that little bit of support. And at this stage, bump might be getting quite large, so you can either place your hands just underneath to give you a sense of support, or maybe placing your hands somewhere around mid-belly, wherever you feel your room to be. And you close your eyes here as you gently start to bring your focus into the felt sensation of your breath. Feeling the breath move in and down. And the exhale rising up. Watching your breath as it sort of rises and falls like waves. The breath in, almost like that pulling of the wave till it reaches its crest. And the breath out as it crashes onto the shore. Breath in, sort of empowering you with that strength and force of the ocean. And that breath out, you're helping to clear any sort of anxiety or fears as it washes onto the shore. So breathing in, strength. Breathing out, letting go. Now we'll gently begin to find a little bit of movement here through the neck. Maybe a little bit of side to side movement. Or maybe rolling of your chin gently across your chest from side to side, just exploring around the area of your neck. Maybe this movement starts to turn into more of a circular movement. As you find some space and freedom in your neck. Gently bringing that movement to a close, we'll blink the eyes open. Maybe your gaze is down and the first thing you see is baby bump. And then we'll allow the hands to come all the way up and out to the side as we reach up. And then exhale, palms come to touch at the center of the chest. We'll do that a couple of times. Breathing in, arms reach up, finding that sense of space through the sides of the body. Exhale, palms come down, letting go of fear and anxiety. Breathing in to lift up. Exhale. Drawing in towards your sense of strength. One more time, breathing in. Exhale, softening down. This time, as the arms reach up, keep your right arm lifting as you float your left fingertips towards the ground and take a side stretch. See if you can open up a little bit through the right side of the body a little bit more without collapsing too much into your left side body. Breathe in, come up through center, and exhale, take it to the other side. And that beautiful side stretch, opening up, giving yourself and baby more room as baby starts to take up more space in your body. And you start to find a sense of freedom through the breath. We do it one more time. Either side. And then gently, palms come back to touch in the center of the chest. We'll do a little bit of a warm-up now for the wrists. So imagine that your wrists are sort of magnetized towards one another. I'm going to roll the fingertips towards you, and then the fingertips point out, and then come in, out, and in, just warming up through your wrists. And then change direction. And just taking your time. Everything happens a little bit slower right now. Good. Okay. We're going to gently come down onto our hands and knees. Just going to pop the bolster up to the side. I'm going to suggest having some blocks here just to give you and baby a little bit more space. So your hands up on the blocks, and that's going to just give you that sense of spaciousness through the upper body. And here we're just going to find a little bit of movement, something that maybe feels nice in your body. Sometimes it's a little bit of rotational movement through the hips. Maybe you make little circles here, making them as long or small as feels good in your body. Make for those little pockets of tension that feel particularly nice to take a little stretch into. And if you've been making rotations in one direction, we'll just go the opposite way. And we're going to step that right foot forward to the outside of your right hand, and do a little bit of back and forth movement into that hamstring. As you come forward, have a little bit of engagement through your left glutes, so that you're not just collapsing into your hip socket. So building that strength on one side, a little bit of mobility. Gently bring your right elbow into that right knee for support. I quite like to spin the back foot out here, and then we're going to reach up and open it through that left arm. Bring it back down, closing the chest a little bit, moving in, lifting up, opening up through the chest. Back down, open. Exhale to bring it back down. Good. See if you can lift that right leg, send it back behind. Take a little mini balance, hips level, a little bit of toning through your lower tummy. So transverse abdominis here, kind of hugging baby inwards, and then gently releasing your right leg to the ground. It might feel nice to take a little bit of movement. And then we'll step that left foot forward. So again, just grounding through that left foot, as we find a little bit of movement back and forth, inviting that kind of release through the hamstring, and not just diving into that right hip socket, right, feeling that little bit of engagement through the right glute. So you switch on and come forward. And then taking a little pause as we bring the left elbow to the left knee. Maybe that left foot spins in. Sorry, right foot. Reach up and open through the arm. And then place it down. Lift up, open. And lower down. Last one. Open up. Shoulder, chest. And then hand to the earth. And again, we're with that little balance. Switching that foot back behind you. Taking that little adjustment of the hips to their level, and then gently placing that foot all the way to the left. You can either come down into your hands out, or keep your blocks where they are to head up into a downward facing dog. I'm just going to pop onto the side for now. So you can walk your hands a little bit further forward, tuck your toes under, press up and back into a downward facing dog. Find as much space as you need, right? But step really wide with the feet. If it's feeling like a bit too much on the wrist, you simply come down into your forearm dog, either kneeling or knees up. We'll take a couple of breaths here, whichever position you've chosen. Starting to find a little bit of movement through the calf muscles. So, for example, if you're in kneeling, you could stretch back through one leg and then back through the other leg. Like the same kind of effect, wherever you are, is perfect. Listen to your body. So now we're going to lower the knees all the way down to the earth. Walk the hands all the way back. Grab one of your blocks. We're going to come to sitting. Virasana, so kneeling. This one gives you a nice stretch through the front of the thighs. It opens you up a little bit through the front belly. Walk the hands back behind, taking a breath in, opening up through the chest. Maybe the gaze lifts. You do not have to throw your head back. You can keep your gaze looking straight ahead as well. And then gently coming all the way back. Walk yourself back through to our tabletop shape. Maybe tuck the toes under and push back into a downward facing dog. Breathing here. Lower the knees, pop that block up to the side, we don't need it for a moment. Walk your hands up, lift the knees. So you come into this little bit of a squatting position. And find a little bit of movement here to begin with. So you're always kind of exploring the sense of mobility to your hips. It feels quite nice to find that movement, a little bit of a flowing sense in the body as we practice. Take the hands to the earth to support you as you lift up through into this kind of forward folding position. You can walk your feet nice and wide, allow your forehead to soften down towards the ground. Yeah, take up as much space as you need. You might use that block to give you a little support here, or you could even be supporting your baby bump as you're here. Breathe in. Out. Maybe there's a little bit of swing that happens from side to side. As you gently release through the back body. And then you bend the knees to take a slow rise all the way up through to standing. Come on, I'm going to step wide onto the mat. So I'm going to face this way so I can continue to see you. You step as wide as feels comfortable for you. We're going to come through a little bit of a flowing movement. So let's turn the right toes out to the side. Your left toes can be facing forward, or you can turn them in a little bit if that feels okay. And then we're going to extend the arms up. We're going to take a little flowing triangle. So reaching the arm down, right arm towards the right leg, and then coming all the way back up and taking a reverse triangle to the opposite side. We'll take a couple of these, just gently flowing from one side to the other, building that strength through the core muscles at the side of our bodies. The glutes and all the muscles that kind of support you and your back at this time. Hips come back through center, we'll spin the right toes in as we spin the left toes out. And we'll do the same here. Reaching forward into a kind of trikonasana and reaching back into reverse trikonasana. Gently from one side to the other. Filling that space through the side body as you come up and over, and building the strength as you lift. We'll come back through center, taking the hands onto the hips. It might feel nice to either walk your feet in a little bit closer or simply starting to find a little bit of movement. You could also have hands on back. Circling around, gently releasing across the muscles of the hips. Maybe a couple of times in the opposite direction as well. Finding what feels nice, what feels good. And then we're going to heel toe our feet in towards one another once again. So they don't have to be super close, but maybe hip distance apart. And then you're going to bend your knees, sink the sitting bones down and back as you reach your arms up and forward, coming into a little bit of a chair pose. find that sense of length through both sides of your body. Soften your ribs in a little bit so they're not flaring. You're thinking about that length through the torso, opening you out. And gently bring your palms to touch as you come back up through to standing. We're going to take our blocks now and make a little bit of a support here. So stacking one block on top of the other. And then we're going to head down into a squat so you can stay with your feet quite wide. Palms coming to touch as we sink all the way down into a squatting position. So there's this kind of gentle opening through the inner thighs. Really beautiful preparation for breath pose. Spine is tall. We're going to breathe deep into the belly. A focus on sort of relaxation of the muscles around your pelvic floor as we breathe in and out. There's a natural toning through the exhale as you breathe out, so you don't need to focus on it, especially if you're past 36 weeks. You want to just focus on that relaxation through the pelvis. We'll take another few breaths here. And if it feels like you want a little bit more, a little bit of heat building, perhaps reaching your arms up, or just keep the arms down and in. So breathing deep into your belly. Feel that softening and relaxation through the pelvic floor. One more deep breath. And then gently take the palms to touch in front of your chest. Take the hands onto the ground to gently support us into lifting into that forward fold once again. You can just swivel your blocks out towards you. So you come into this kind of squatting position once again. So that's quite a wide-legged forward fold. Then we're going to swivel the heels in, drop the hips low. So we come into this a little bit more of a strengthener through the inner thighs. You might just feel a little gentle kind of bounce here, up and down. Feeling into that inner thighs working. And that's going to help to bring that little bit of strength into the pelvis as well. So we stay here, or we start to build a little bit of a flow into it. So we reach up and over, come back through, and take the side stretch to the opposite side. Gently back and forth. Going at your own pace and rhythm. Breathing into belly, towards baby. Last time, this way, and back up through center. From here, we can straighten the legs all the way out. It should feel quite nice to gently release and let go. It might feel like natural to take a little bit of a hip rotation here as well. We'll walk the feet in together and we're going to head down to seated. So come down, we'll take our time. Welcome to the back of your mat, bend your knees, hands to knees, and then walk yourself all the way back out, either to a downward facing dog or straight down to neutral. We'll sink the hips back to the heels. Sit over onto your whichever hip you prefer, and then we'll extend the legs out. Take the soles of your feet to touch. So this is Baddha Konasana, which is a really beautiful shape to take. Also in your third trimester, I'm going to suggest taking your hands back behind you, lift the chest, opening up, and then maybe lift the hips a little bit. If you want to bring them closer to the heels, you can, but it could feel really nice to just keep your feet a little bit further out from you today. And then we'll take the hands either to your shins or your knees, wherever feels comfortable. We're going to start a little bit of circular movement here, getting into this kind of rotational movement through the spine once again. So again, it can be slower or faster, and you choose how far forward you go, how deep you go back into that little back bend. And we'll go the opposite way. Should feel really nice. You can get your shoulders moving as well into this rotational movement. And then you can gently gather your knees together, hugging them up. We're going to set ourselves up for our final resting shape. So you take your blocks back behind, one on the two, it's horizontal, middle level, and the other one vertically on its sort of highest setting. And then with your bolster or your cushions, using them as a support structure to make sure it's nice and stable. Sometimes they get a little wound. And then we'll sit up around to the left hip, one hand to either side of your bolster. Make sure that this comfortable here as you climb down onto your bolster. Knees could stay stacked, or you could take one leg back behind. But just be mindful if there's any sort of iliac stuff going on, just want to keep the knees together in a neutral position for your pelvis. From here, we'll close the eyes. Begin to step in the breath. Just checking the back, squashing it deep into your body. Breathing out through your mouth on the exhale. And through the nose. Out through the mouth. Out through the nose. Out through the and letting go of you. You're welcome to stay here for as long as you like. Or we're going to gently ease up out of this position. We come into a simple cross-legged shape. Around our heart, sit hand, and baby. Once again, breath, heart, baby. Thank you so much for joining me today. Lovely to see you. Take care.